6-5 Oakland Raiders going up against 6-5 Kansas City. Week 13 is here, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome. Huge AFC West battle coming down today. This could potentially decide the division. I mean, still a couple weeks left. We've still got Kansas City one more time, and I think Denver one more time. But this is a big one coming up. And we also have a QB controversy. Norv Turner hasn't said it yet, but we could potentially be seeing Kerry Collings today. I'm not sure yet. We'll have to see. It's a game time decision. He's trying to hide his cards because that really makes a difference. But with how poorly Rich Gannon's been playing this season, we could definitely see Kerry Collings and his stronger arm coming out today. But week 13's here. Let's just get right into it.
When do you tell your wife she's getting fat?
Guess what you came down the stairs wearing? Sweatpants.
So what?
My sweatpants.
A new King of Queens, CBS Wednesday.
CBS Sports welcomes you to the following presentation of the National Football League.
Here with me in the booth, my longtime associate, Peter O'Keefe. Peter, this game has got a playoff atmosphere with a chance at the number one spot in the division at stake.
Well, the pressure's on, Dan. You better believe it. Can secure number one in their division with a win. And with these kind of matchups, it all comes down to rhythm. Whatever team can establish an offensive and defensive rhythm earliest will come away with the win.
Janikowski boots the opening kickoff. Blaylock catches it back at the 10. Tackled at the 32-yard line. They couldn't connect on this one. Incomplete. Peter, unfortunately, we've had some players banged up so far.
Unfortunately so. As we can see here, we've got the injuries that have accrued over the season and...
36. Green throws a heater and it's tipped. Incomplete. Bowler makes the catch out to the left, and that's not enough. He's short of the marker. Vargas takes his first carry of the game and rambles for about five. Collings passes this one after the play. And it's intercepted. Stopped at the 39.
Come on. I'm coming out. Okay. 36 on your
back. Oh, no. Takes it across the line and Tony gets back to the line of scrimmage. Not going to get free, regardless of how evasive you are.
Not with that strength. With those guns, you could probably juggle bowling balls, or wide receivers, for that matter.
Holmes gains 10 yards on the play, and that will bring up first down. Holmes will get the carry on first down and moves forward for 7.
Double down there, Dan. This time, the D one.
Horton goes in motion. Holmes hits the ball on third down and lowers his shoulder for the first. Rodman tackles him behind the line of scrimmage.
59!
Smith gets the sack at the 9. That will bring up 4th and goal.
Play man in the backfield for a big loss. I don't know what happened to protection. Let's have a look.
Fourth down, and the field goal unit is on the field. They take the lead. Raiders were intercepted last time out. We'll see what happens here. We'll start at their own 24-yard line. Vargas gains 3 yards, and that brings up second down. Collins launches it out left side, and the catch is made well past the markers for a first down.
Pass interference, number 44, defense. The penalty is declined.
Vegeta gets the sack way back at the 36. That'll do it for quarter number one. The Chiefs with a small lead, 3-0.
We're the concrete or cement brothers.
We're cement brothers, yeah.
My brother told me about the Quaker Oat Challenge. What it boiled down to was eating the oatmeal for 30 days. Quaker Oats helps lower your cholesterol.
Bottom line.
I dropped it 6 points. Eat it, all right?
When it comes to a vacation, some travel light, others don't. But this year, when you stay at a Disney Resort Hotel, you can completely skip baggage claim and we'll take you and your luggage from Orlando International Airport to your Walt Disney World vacation. For more about Disney's Magical Express complimentary service, visit DisneyWorld.com. And you'll never have to lift a paw.
Thursday, February 17th, 20 of the wildest survivors hit the beach.
I will either be loved or hated.
I'm a strong Christian. That's the way I try to live my life.
I have the freak factor working for me.
I'm gonna be the first redneck to win $1 million.
Now they face the biggest twist ever. No help of any kind.
Oh my God.
My family told me right off the bat that if I'm the first one voted off, don't come home.
Survivor Palau premieres CBS Thursday, February 17th.
First on third and long. Right down at the 27. They will start this drive at their own 27-yard line. Green zings it to the right side, and they can't connect. Green throws this on a rope, and it's caught at the 32, eventually tackle at the 41. First down. Kennison brings down the floater and gets past the markers for a first down. Kennison goes in motion. Green zings it to the right side, and it's tipped, incomplete. Fumble. The Raiders have it. Coach Vermeil doesn't agree with the call, and we're going to see the red flag.
Hey, we want a challenge.
Kansas City is challenging whether it was a back pass.
This is their first challenge of the game, and even if they lose this one, they still have one challenge left.
Dan, we've got to look at the pass itself and see whether the ball is moving forward or backwards.
After review, the play has been ruled a forward pass and therefore incomplete. Kansas City will not be charged for timeout. Third down.
He likes the call, and you sort of have a feeling that he knew it all along. Forces him to drop the ball onto it as they start this drive at their own 7-yard line. gets the call on first down and heads up field. No one in front of him. First down right at the 45. That will bring up first down. Well, he saw the tackle coming and he spins out of danger for a big game.
He spun around three times. You can get Dan, but they were, you know, hoping for more.
Second down. 9 yards to go. He's got the first down and a whole lot more.
He's going the distance.
The defender.
A well-designed play there, Peter. Barton takes this one way out left, and Collins throws a bullet to the flat, and the catch is made at the 14. Back down at the 8. It'll be first and goal.
Must be wondering if he's in the twilight zone, Dan. There's absolutely no one there to cover him. It doesn't get much easier than that. Yep, the D looks exactly what he did. Dan, bunch of receivers out there. Defense is expecting that, and they go to nickel.
One man to beat, and he's in for the touchdown. Makes a play on this and forces the incompletion. Four wideouts in the game. Green throws a big high lob and it's intercepted. Brought down at the 41.
He doesn't have a shot at it unless he jumps for it. That man, he timed it perfectly to give his receivers a few tips about shooting.
Catches this one and he picks up 9. Second down, both tight ends left. Collins airs this one to the left sideline and it's knocked away from the receiver. Incomplete. Collins decides to run this instead and climbs to a first down.
But he takes care of business throughout this play. Makes me want to hit the gym again and maybe, you know, get back down there on the field.
First down from the shotgun. First down of Bonds at the 12. It will be first down.
Across the field and finds his man. That, my friends, is a strong arm.
Peter, that's his first touchdown pass. Here's the extra point, and it's good. Motion. Holmes gains 5 on the play. And that'll do it for the first half of this one. The Raiders enjoying the lead 14-3. And now let's send you to Chris Berman in our studios in Bristol for the ESPN Halftime Report. Boomer?
Okay, Dana, we'll get back to you guys in a moment. Welcome, everybody, to the ESPN Halftime Show. I'm Chris Berman. Now let's take a look at the halftime stats. And boy, look at the difference in rushing yards. The Chiefs are certainly losing because of it. It's hard to win when you play like that. We'll send you back now to the second half of this one. Dan Stevens and Peter O'Keefe are there. Gentlemen.
Thanks, Chris. And today's game has been presented in ESPN Game Sound. Designed and developed in collaboration with Dolby. By them could really open up this game. They currently lead 14-3. Let's go down to the field. And start this drive at their own 20-yard line. Marcus cruises out to the left side and... Wesley racks him down and gets the sack way back at the 15. Rice didn't haul that one in on 30-yard line. Holmes catches it in the flat and picks up four on the play. Defense had other ideas.
The anticipation of the throw was key here. It made all the pieces fall into place.
Third down coming up. Woodson kicks it away on the cover. He's incomplete. That will bring up fourth down.
The game. Great read there.
Baker lines up to punt after the three and out. Baker takes the snap and punts it away. Trent fields the punt at the 25. Breaks free, causes a tackle, tackled at the 36. Well, Peter, some interesting information up on the screen.
Oh, you bet. They've turned the ball over, but they have survived their mistakes. But you can't survive that kind of sloppy play for long. It's going to come back to bite you.
Sims sacks him way back at the 31. Motion. Hicks sacks him back at the 26. It'll be fourth down. Defense has taken the field, and they have been having a very tough time passing the ball. They have another opportunity here as they start off at their 40-yard line. Catches it over the middle, and he's got the first down and a whole lot more. Holmes loses one on the play, and that brings up second down. Holmes catches the lob over the middle, and he's looking for room. And this is nothing but read and react, Peter, which is what all defenders are taught.
Great concentration to nab one shifty runner, stepping up and doing his job.
Anderson with the 44-yard attempt and has it sailed just left of the upright. Collins throws it to the left sideline, and it's knocked away from the Reese three passes. And, you know, you can tell he's starting to get frustrated.
Yeah, all he needs to do is calm down and make the throw.
Rice grabs the fastball over the middle, and they get the first on third and long. Vargas catches it in the flat, and that's a gain of seven on the play.
Holding, number 65, offense.
10-yard penalty. Listen up! Collins makes the long pass, and it's off. Incomplete. Marcus gets it snapped directly to him and runs into traffic, crosses the field. Wesley makes a play on this one and forces the incompletion.
Incomplete pass.
And return.
The Chiefs had their last drive stall out at the end. We'll see if they can keep momentum throughout this one, which starts at their own 24-yard line.
66!
Holmes pulls the ball down and is at the 30. Dragged down at the 34.
Good denial there.
Second down coming up. Salas makes a top catch. He's got the first down and a whole lot more. Yet another batted ball. And I'll tell you, he's really playing well out there.
He's been after the ball from the beginning of the game. Real aggressive play.
Gonzalez catches it in the flat and gets past the markers for a first down.
Tony Gonzalez will not take no for an answer. Watch this play where he makes the catch and then knifes ahead for plenty more.
Peter, there's another catch, and for a tight end, he sees the ball quite a bit.
Well, he's one of those guys that's more of a receiver than a tight end, Dan. He's got such great hands that he'll get the ball a lot during this game.
Montana throwing under pressure. Caught by Clark.
It's a new chapter in an old, familiar story.
He died. Touchdown.
Be there when the 49er legacy begins anew. Right now, for a limited time, a select number of individual 49er tickets are available. Good seats are on sale now. Get ready, 49er fans. This may be your only chance to get in the game.
Breaks outside. Custer is left. Back up the middle. Into the end zone. Touchdown, 49ers.
Tickets available only at 49ers.com or Ticketmaster.
Wednesday on a new CSI New York, their next case...
Maybe he's some kind of escape artist.
...will be a three-ring circus, literally. It's the Big Top in the Big Apple like you've never seen it before.
This one's a real tough guy.
We handle things internally.
So do we.
A new CSI New York, CBS Wednesday.
California lottery winnings going way up. Details at 11.
Holmes picks up six on the play and... His number called on second down and picks up the first down.
Yeah, buddy.
Hacking the pass every chance they get.
That's right, Dan. You know, why simply defend the pass when you can obliterate?
Third down, and this is the 12th play of the drive. Anderson from 29 yards out, and this one is up and in. And we'll see if they can get back on track here. This drive begins at their own 21-yard line. Vargas takes it off the toss and jukes to a first down. Vargas carries it for the 12th time and chews up about four on the play.
34! Listen up! Down!
Catches it left sideline, and he's got the first down and a whole lot more.
Down!
Hicks takes him down way. Collins tosses it down the left side, and it's not. Sapp tackles him behind the line of scrimmage. It looks like, we've had an injury down on the field as Johnson gets the call and passes the Raiders. Have a short field and will start this drive at the 43-yard line. Barber takes him down back at the 47.
Hyena, red, 56. Hyena, red, 56. Hyena.
Vargas takes it for his 17th carry and heads out right, crosses the field.
Holding. Number 65. Offense. The penalty is declined.
With the clock at 1:46. Green unloads this to the right sideline and the reception's made at the 37. 30, 20, 10. Touchdown! The time.
Blue 19.
Kennison didn't haul that one in, and it falls incomplete. They're setting up for the onside kick. Anderson bounces it up. Dunn gathers it up at the 37. Hands team.
Gutsy play calling, too. It worked out beautifully.
The Chiefs start this drive of the game from well in their own territory, and the clock at 1:35. Green fires this one over the middle, and the catch is made well past the markers for a first down.
Face mask, number 30. Defense. 15-yard
penalty, automatic first down. Down! This one will fall incomplete. Horton makes the nice catch, and he gets the go-ahead touchdown.
Johnny Morton had three guys covering him, but look what happens.
Incredible catch.
That touchdown will give them the lead. Collins throws a bullet to the flat, and the catch is made, and the clock continues to wind down. Hearts hammers the receiver and forces it up third down.
Nice pressure that time.
Hargis takes the snap and runs into traffic. Tackled, and the clock will continue to run. The Raiders will take it. Collins keeps this one himself and converts the fourth down. What a fantastic play. First down, two wideouts on the field. Collins throws a high, long one to the right, and it's complete for the first down and a whole lot more.
Face mask, number 44, defense. 5-yard penalty from the spot of the pop.
Runs out, and that will stop the clock at 21. That will bring up first.
Collins
throws it to the left sideline, and the catch is made. The Raiders take a timeout. Porter didn't haul that one in, and it falls incomplete. Gets the sack, and the clock continues to run. And that is going to do it for this one. The Chiefs come out on top 19-14. For my partner, Peter O'Keefe, this is Dan Stevens saying goodbye until next time.
Dan, thank you. So this one is in the books as we welcome you all to our ESPN Video Games post-game show. I'm Chris Berman. The Chiefs stepped it up for sure, putting up some good numbers. Now let's catch up with the player who really ignited his team's offense with his deft passing and has earned our Player of the Game award. Trent Green is on the sidelines with Susie Calvert. Susie?
Thanks, Chris. You transcended the competition today, and you nosed them out in this nail-biter game. What was the key to your success?
Well, as you know, our defense played great. They were getting after the ball and hustling all game long. We just got fired up from watching them play. It was a nice effort all around.
Chris, back to you.
Thanks for tuning into ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports for 25 years and counting. I'm Chris Berman. We'll see you next time.
Hand up that not was not great clock management at the end. Not good. I should have spiked it with those 16 seconds and kept timeout. Probably would have had about 10 seconds left, but I still would have had the timeout in my back pocket at least. But you obviously can't take a sack there. That was inexcusable. That cost us the game. But wow, what a tight one. And that is going to be huge in the playoff race. That is going to really hurt us, because now I don't think we really even control our destiny anymore. We're on the outside looking in now, big time. Let's finish up the week here, see how everything looks after week 13. Only 4 games left in the season with Mike Vick on deck. We got our work cut out for us. Yeah. 7-5, Kansas City now has the division, complete control of the division, I think, I'm pretty sure, and then we're on the outside looking in with Denver having the head-to-head over us, so this second half of the season is not going the way I thought we were going to go. I thought we were going to be kind of walking into the playoff race by now with how strong we started, but we're going to need help now, big time. So we're pretty much looking at a wild card. So Atlanta Falcons up next. We're going to need help our way. We'll check out everybody else on the other schedules next time, too, to see where we can get our help. But we don't really control our destiny anymore. But with that, thanks for checking out, guys. We'll see you next week.
all right?